నమస్కారం అందరికి. ఈ వీడియోను వీక్షిస్తున్న వారికి నా పేరు భూషణ్ భవనం. ఈరోజు నేను మాట్లాడేది జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారి వ్యక్తిత్వాన్ని తెలుగుదేశం పార్టీ ఎట్లా క్యారెక్టర్ అసాసినేట్ చేసింది అనేది. జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారిని ఒక ఫ్యాక్షనిస్ట్ అన్నారు, లక్ష కోట్లు దోచుకున్నారు, సైకో అని ఎన్నో కారణాలతో జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారి దే హావ్ అసాసినేటెడ్ ద క్యారెక్టర్ ఆఫ్ జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు. బికాస్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద మీడియా, ఐ థింక్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ 8 మీడియా ఛానల్స్ ఆర్ ఓన్ బై వన్ ఒక సామాజిక వర్గానికి సంబంధించింది. సో ఇన్ ద ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ అసాసినేటింగ్ ద క్యారెక్టర్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు, దే ప్రొజెక్టెడ్ హిమ్ యాజ్ అ ఫ్యాక్షనిస్ట్ ఆర్ ల్యాండ్ గ్రాబర్ సంథింగ్ లైక్ దట్. అండ్ ఐ థింక్ our party failed in defending these issues because of lack of enough efficient spokesman. One point is that, and on top of that, Jagan Mohan Reddy gar believes in a formula that he has to stand by his word. Like, for example, if he has given word for 100 people, he believes in the formula that he has to stand by all the 100, even though some of them, if we find out in the later stage that they're inefficient, he still stand on his word and all, and he doesn't make any false promises. And it will take for the people for a little longer to understand what our leader is. But eventually, initially the truth initially seems like losing, but at the end the truth always wins. And this is my concept. And whereas Chandrababu Naidu doesn't have a reason to win the election in 2014, but he has fragmented all the little fragments and made it together by giving all the false promises, like Raitu Runa Mafi or Dwakara Runa Mafi or Babu Vaste Jabu Vastadi, like, you know, for the youth and all. By hook or crook, he want to come into power. Whereas Jagan Mohan Reddy, even he'll be happy if he doesn't come into power, but he want to be a truthful guy. He want to keep his promises, whatever given to the public. He doesn't mind sitting in opposition, but he believes in the truth, what his father has taught or what his mother has taught. This is the reason he lost 2014 elections. Now that the people have understood him very clearly, and people also believe that Jagan Mohan Reddy garu is not a factionist, he's an proven entrepreneur. I'll say a small example. If you take a media baron like Mr. Ramoji Rao, who has got vast experience in this media, and is lot of people have floated many newspapers like Udayam, Varta, Jyoti, whatever. Nobody can come close to him. At the age of 35, Jagan Mohan Reddy garu has opened Sakshi channel, Sakshi newspaper, and he has given very tough competition and came to first or second position, very tough competition for Enadu. This shows his entrepreneur skills, and he has got power projects, he has got Bharati Cement. Whatever the project he does as an entrepreneur, he excelled. So I believe a leader who has got experience as entrepreneur, successful entrepreneur, like ఉద్యోగ భద్రత యువతకు, అంటే ఫర్ యంగ్స్టర్స్ టు ప్రొవైడ్ ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్, లీడర్ షుడ్ హ్యావ్ గుడ్ ఎంటర్ప్రెన్యూరల్ స్కిల్స్. దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు హెస్ గాట్. అండ్ ఇఫ్ యూ వాచ్ హిమ్ ఫ్రమ్ క్లోజ్, యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ హిజ్ నేచర్ ఈస్. హీస్ అ వెరీ గుడ్ నేచర్డ్ జైబ్, మిస్టర్ జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు. People, it will take a little longer to understand him, but once people understand, it will, people will keep him on the seat for a long period. That is what the main aim of Shri Jagan Mohan Reddy garu. But he wants to stand on the truth. That is when the ruling of the state will become easy. If he makes false promises, he has to, you know, bend his head, fall on people's feet to get funds from the nation and from the center. So he wants to be on truth, whatever is possible he promises, and he'll come into power, and he lasts and longs for a long period of time. This is my opinion. Thank you.